Now the second condition is side angle side, or you can say SAS congruence. According to this condition, if two sides and the included angle of one triangle are respectively equal to the corresponding two sides and the included angle of the other, then we can say that the two triangles are congruent. Let's understand by an example. Here you have two triangles ABC and triangle PQR. So in this triangle ABC and PQR, you have side AB equals to side PQ and side AC equals to side PR. And you also have one equal angle, that is angle A is equals to angle P. So we can say that the triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR under SAS congruence condition. In this statement of SAS congruence, we had read a term included angle. What this included angle means? This included angle means that the angle should lie between two sides of the given triangles. Now, let's understand the concept of SAS congruence by an example from your book. In the given figure, QT and RS bisect each other at P. You have to show that triangle QPR is congruent to triangle TPS and QR is equals to ST. So in triangle QPR and triangle TPS, we have QP equals to TP, and we'll write the reason as P is the midpoint of QT. Side RP is equals to side SP. We'll write the reason as P is the midpoint of RS. And the third condition which is equal is angle QPR and angle TPS equal, as they will form vertically opposite angle, as it is given in question that QT and RS bisect each other at point P. So we all know that when a straight line intersect each other, they will form vertically opposite angle and they are always equal. So we can write as angle QPR is equals to angle TPS, and we'll write the reason also vertically opposite angles. And as you can see that this angle which are equal lie between two sides of triangle. So we can say that this triangle QPR is congruent to triangle TPS by SAS congruence. Now we'll solve B part. We know that triangle QPR is congruent to triangle TPS, as we have just proved above in A part. So we can say that QR is equals to TS by CPCT. And what the CPCT stands for? Corresponding part of congruent triangle. As these two triangles are congruent, therefore we can say that QR is equals to TS.